Yossi has asked me to give a little talk about installing Replicate on Linux to go over, I think, a few points that you'll need to know, problems you might run into, and a few questions. So let's just start here. We install Replicate on Linux with this program called RPM. Stands for Red Hat Package Manager. It's a utility. You know, the documentation lays out pretty well the parameters and the options that you can do. You know, just like on Windows, you can use a non-default installation directory. You can change the data directory. The only difference is you set up the user that runs the Replicate service. Unlike Windows, there is only one process. There are no two services, a Replicate server service and a Replicate UI service. There is only one integrated service, which could lead to, problems, but questions with people who are familiar to Windows. The major thing is that there are three different options for the user interface, the UI. By default, the UI runs on Linux, and the only access you have is through the user, the administrative user called admin. When that happens, there is no users tab under the server's view of the Replicate UI. There's only the one user. The second option is that you can integrate the authentication mechanism with this Linux authentication method called PAM, password authentication method. When you do that, you still have no users under the users tab because the users that you get through PAM. And in point of fact, every single user in PAM is now authorized to use the Replicate UI. When they do so, they are all administrators. There are no roles in Linux. Beyond this is that PAM can be configured to use the Windows Active Directory, which case it's kind of between the Linux and the Windows world because you have all your Windows user in Active Directory with access, but they're all administrators. And then finally, with the third option, you can install Replicate on Windows and have it point to the Linux server, in which case the UI would then run on Windows, and it behaves just like Windows Replicate in that sense, but now the users will connect to the UI running on Windows. You could still have users connecting directly to the UI on Linux, but then it would behave just as if whatever user you've got in PAM, and they would be administrators. Some interesting features is that Replicate 6.2 and newer supports multiple instances server or VM. And what happens there is that all instances have the same bin directory, and so they would be running the same version. You can't easily have multiple versions running on Linux. Now, you could if you get beneath the covers and play around with the install, but the problem is the install that Replicate uses RPM, and there's one RPM data store, so you can't really install two versions in RPM. You'd have to manually install it, which is, again, is beyond the scope, and maybe some of the people in PS know how to do that, but it can be done. It's just frowned upon, I mean, because, you know, Linux machines or VMs are so cheap, just have a second one. When you use Enterprise Manager, the connection string uses the default port and a valid user, or if you want to use Enterprise Manager to connect to the Windows UI and you have the Windows UI, then you would use, you know, the HTTPS port and a valid user for that. Changing the Replicate data directory can be done during installation, but not an update of an existing installation, but a new installation, or with this shell script arep.sh, which is documented in the Replicate user guide. Now, it's interesting that we have some customers that have had problems trying to change the data directory on installation. Doing some debugging, we've seen that what they did was they installed Replicate previously and then uninstalled it, but the uninstall does not remove the services list text file. The installation script that runs when you use RPM that Qlik provides, checks the services list file. It puts it where it formerly was in the services list file and not where you tell it to go when you run the installation. Now, the workaround for that problem is you have to remove the services list file before you do the second install, or if you try and install, do it a third time, you have to uninstall and remove the list file. If you then can't start the service, and that's because the UMask for the root user is incorrect. When you run RPM, you have to be root. Oftentimes, the root user has a more circumscribed UMask, and the UMask is used for defining the permissions for files that the user creates. And then the other thing is that if you have a failure on installation, you can fix the problem and redo it, or you can also run the arep.sh script to move the data directory. That also works. There was an interesting problem. There's a configuration file called repctl.cfg. This would be an upgrade. Looks to see if this file exists. And if it exists, it puts out a warning message, tells the user that they have to merge it, should continue on its way. The only problem is currently in 6.6 and 6.5, when this happens, the installation comes to a stop instead of finishing. And so the replicate is betwixt and between. It's not installed, can't run it, but you can't uninstall it either because it's missing pieces. So I opened an internal issue. And there've also been at least four customer issues that I know of. And so as I said, the system is unstable because there's no areplicate script, so you can't run it. And there's no areplicate script, so you can't uninstall it. Now you can force the uninstall by using this no scripts option to RPM. I don't know if that's documented. And also note, because I'm using PowerPoint here, that's actually two dashes in front of no scripts, not one dash. So there's a way to get around the problem. Okay, so some questions that we got. Let's see, what permissions are needed for the install? Install and update has to be done as root. So on Linux, the root user has access to everything. So you don't necessarily need to provide permissions, but you need to make sure that the UMask is set such that other users will be able to have access, because what happens is that the install or the update downloads and runs as root, but then it changes the owner of all the files to be the Attunity user. How do we debug the installation? When you run RPM, you can pass it some arguments, and our script that we provide uses two variables called debug and verbose, which are by default set to false, but if you can set them to true, and then the installation will print out more information. What are the directories used for the installation? Are they different than the folders with Windows? They're the same. The only difference, not so much in the directories, but the files. With Windows, you have some XML files used, and instead on Linux, we use the repctl.cfg, that configuration file instead of XML files. But otherwise, it's almost identical. Can there be one UI server? On Linux, the UI and the server processes are integrated, so there's no separate UI server. If you use a Windows UI, you would have a separate UI process on Windows. Even though you do have Windows UI, you can also directly connect to the Linux UI, but that is usually not done. In order to do so, you would have to have the password for an account that's allowed. And typically, if you use the Windows UI, you're not going to connect it on Linux to PAM, so there's only going to be the one admin user, which is set by the person that installs it. So if you don't tell anyone the password, you can't use the Linux UI. You would have to only use the Windows UI. When Enterprise Manager is connected to the Linux Replicate server, where should it connect to? The UI or the server? If you're not using the Windows UI, there is no choice. There's only one place to connect. Use the REST port, and then when using the Windows UI, you can connect it to either the Windows UI or directly to Linux. But if the person who did the installation has kept the password for the admin user secret, then you can only connect to the Windows UI. So the last question, when Enterprise Manager is connected to Linux, can the UI work as well? Yeah, sure. It's Enterprise Manager is, you know, just another consumer, so you can have people connecting to the UI as well. That's all the stuff that I have prepared. Bye-bye, everyone.